trivia is today's theme. Tonight, our guest on the open mic is Gene Jones, known as America's Trivia Guy. He's the creator and host of a trivia game show of his own and is an official judge for the Guinness Book of World Records. And tonight, he's our guest on the open mic.
All right, Gene, let's get right into it, okay? How long have you been in the business?
Well, I've been in entertainment business for about 30 years. I've been doing the game show for 25.
25 years in the game show. And when you look at the trivia, okay, why is trivia so popular? You look at different shows out there, Jeopardy and all these different things. Why is it so popular?
Well, first of all, it's not just those shows. Mm-hmm. Trivia on a grassroots level is in bars and restaurants. There's team leagues and all kinds of things around the country and actually worldwide. So trivia has this appeal in that it's a challenge. And it helps people find out what the other people and they share in common. So if I ask you a trivia question about some subject I'm passionate about and you know the answer, maybe there's more conversation for us to have. And that kind of spreads out to the point where people really, really find trivia challenging as well as socially very positive.
When you look at a lot of these different shows, the trivia shows, different game shows, and people can answer any question about anything you wonder, do they really know all that? Are they giving them this information? You look at trivia, is it useless information in their head, or just that guys are very intuitive?
Well, I think there is probably a lot of stuff kind of shaking around there like nuts and bolts. Mm-hmm. I mean, some of these people study obscure information all the time. They scour for it. But on the other hand, if you take trivia questions that have social relevance, educational value, or social value, then actually trivia can be important.
All right, we're in D.C., and this is a sports show.
Yep.
And do you have any, like, I would say, go-to sports questions that you would ask? Or let's say we're in Washington, D.C., if you would ask somebody a question about a D.C. team, what would it possibly be?
Well, one of my favorites is there's two teams in, this is a baseball question, by the way, mm-hmm. there's two teams in the American League now that were once called the Washington Senators.
Okay.
Do you want to take a shot?
Yeah, the Nationals is one.
No.
Okay,
the
Nationals
That's the National
one.
League. And yeah, they used to be the Montreal
wow.
Expos.
Okay.
The Washington Senators, long time ago.
Who are they now?
Well, I'll give you a hint. If you had a sister or a brother that was born exactly the same time as you, what would that person be?
The Twins.
Take a guess.
Minnesota
now.
Twins.
Minnesota Twins
yeah.
is one of them.
All right.
Yep. And let's see, Chuck Norris had a TV show, Walker, Texas.
Ranger. So Texas Rangers.
Texas Rangers is the other one. See, that's how Give Me a Hint works. There's hints behind every question.
All right. Yeah, a question about the Washington Redskins that nobody would know.
Well, this is an obscure one from a long time ago. I happen to have actually seen this show as a kid. What is the highest scoring NFL football game ever?
Okay, I know the answer, so.
Go ahead and tell them.
The New York Giants against the Skins.
That's right, 72-41, 113 total points.
Right? I think Sam Huff was on that team, and I think he was on the Skins side, and he wanted to go out and beat the Giants real bad, because I think they had let him go or something like that.
Could be.
That's what I remember hearing stuff like that. But is trivia more about stuff that you study or things that you catch along the way, just like current events?
For me, it's catch along the way. Mm-hmm. In fact, the whole world, every minute of my life is a potential trivia question. I'm always looking, I read a magazine, I see a TV show, I hear a commercial, could be anything. And if I find some little bit of extra juice in that particular piece of information, it's in the show.
All right, well, I'm sure you are a guy who I think is very studious and you're well prepared. You coming on the Sports Talk Live with Brian Mitchell.
That's right.
You started to figure out the different people and different aspects of this show. I throw out a name, you tell me a question that you would ask. Or you ask me the question, see if I know it. Nicole Darren.
Well, Nicole Darren, in July 2011, Nicole Darren actually did, well, she took a lesson in a particular sport that is the same sport Drew Barrymore did a movie about.
You lost me completely.
Roller derby.
Roller derby?
She actually took a roller derby lesson, and it's on YouTube.
All right, we have, I think we have a young lady that works here in roller derby, so I'm going to have to go and dig a little deeper into that sport.
Take a look at the video.
Myself, Brian Mitchell.
Brian Mitchell. Brian, you know, for all-purpose yards, you're the second all-time leading all-purpose yards mm-hmm. person in the history of the NFL. Who's number one?
Jerry Rice, 23,542 yards.
Oh, you know that one now. You also hold the record for the most all-purpose yards against any single team in the NFL.
Yes.
Which team?
Everybody out there, you gotta love me. Dallas Cowboys.
How about them
there
Cowboys?
There we go. See, those little things I would know.
Right.
Because now, a lot of people tell me things all the time. Now, not that I would know it automatically, because I'm reading different sports things all the time and I pick it up. But you keep that stuff.
Well, I find it interesting. And also, one other thing about you in college, most people may or may not know that you were a quarterback. And you actually hold an NCAA record for quarterbacks. Do you know what it is?
I had a few of them, but I don't remember which one I still have.
Well, you were the first quarterback in the history of the NCAA to throw for 5,000 and rush for over 3,000.
There we go. Well, before we go out, I want you to give me a kooky question.
Well, do you want a really hard one, or what level would you like to do it at?
Make me look smart.
Make you look smart. Okay. Well, I know you're a good cook.
Yeah.
So we could do a cooking question.
Let's do that.
Okay. So if I get Eggs Benedict and they put spinach on top, it's called what?
Spinach
on top makes it what?
I don't know.
Florentine.
That's right.
Florentine.
See, I'm a Cajun.
Ah.
I do the Cajun stuff.
Okay, so you'd have to give me
something about etouffee or jambalaya. I can hook that up.
So you'd have to give me some jambalaya trivia, and it'll be in the show next time.
All right, if I take a turkey and drop it in a lot of grease, what do we call it?
Oh, that's going to be a deep-fried turkey.
All right, Gene, thank you for joining us, man. And I'm going to work on my trivia because I wasn't very good in this show.
And just remember, trivia is important because it exercises the mind.
There you go. Appreciate it.